It's no secret the tablet sales are down in recent years, but Huawei is back with the MediaPad M3. So this is the Huawei MediaPad M3. It's the company's latest tablet, which it announced at IFA 2016. It's the latest in the MediaPad range. It follows on from the MediaPad M2, which was announced earlier this year at CES. Now that tablet was landscape. This one they've decided to, as you can see, orient it portrait-wise, which we actually really like. It is retailing at the moment in euros, it's from 349 euros. So we reckon when it comes on sale at the end of September, it'll be about £300 and up. It's lovely. The build is metallic around the edges and on the back. The edges are nice and chamfered as well. Chamfered is a word that companies love to use, but it does look really nice. And it's quite like the Huawei P9 in design, the smartphone with the dual cameras from this year as well. At first, the screen does seem a little bit narrow, but it did grow on us. It's kind of just like a massive smartphone, but that's not a bad thing. In an overcrowded Android tablet space, it's quite nice to see something with a slightly different form factor, and as you can see, something that I don't mind holding in one hand. It's a good size. It's 8.4 inches from corner to corner, so it sits in between, for you Apple fans, an iPad mini. This would be in the middle in size, and then the iPad Air is slightly bigger. So it's a bit of a niche, the eight inch tablet market, but this is where that is. The display's really nice. It's full HD, it's 2560 by 1600 with a pixel per inch of 359. So basically you can't see any pixels. It looks very nice. It's got good brightness settings and good viewing angles as well. Videos look great on it. No problem reading emails, doing everything you would normally do on a tablet. It's also got a few quirky things with the display, like eye protection, which is kind of a bit of a ripoff of Apple's night shift mode, which basically makes the screen look a bit smoke, nicotine stained. It's meant to help you read at night. I'm not too sure about the whole thing anyway, how well it actually works. And it's not automatic on here, but it's nice to see a few extra features. If we're talking about inside the tablet, then it's Huawei's own processor, what they call their Kirin series. It's a 950 octa-core, which basically just means it's really fast, which is good. It's bang up to date and performed very well on our benchmark test as well. It's got 4 GB of RAM. For comparison, that is about the same, well, it is the same as the full-size iPad Pro, but of course, that doesn't mean it's necessarily as fast. It has a micro SD slot for expandable storage up to 128 GB on the bottom there. Our review unit has inbuilt 32 GB, but it's also available in a 64 variation as well. Optionally is also the LTE model, so you can put a SIM card in that same slot for a cellular plan. And this is quite good on a tablet this size. We reckon this is the sweet spot for cellular tablets. It's not too massive, but it's something you might carry around instead of a laptop to do sort of quick on-the-go emails and stuff with if you want a slightly bigger screen than a smartphone. The device, as you might expect, has two cameras, one on the front here, which is a fixed focus 8 MP camera, and on the back, 8 MP again, but it's an autofocus, which is nice to see. Pretty standard on a tablet. We're not really ones to take pictures with them, but you've got the front-facing one at least for video calling. Interestingly, they've decided Huawei to include micro USB on this device, which is slightly odd just because the company's track record of late is to put the new USB-C standard port on its smartphones, but the MediaPad doesn't include fast charging, which is a little disappointing. The battery, however, lasts ages. It's a 5,100 milliamp hour battery, which is great to get it into such a slim form factor. Software-wise is perhaps where the MediaPad slightly falls down in our estimations. It uses Android Marshmallow 6.0. We are currently a couple of weeks into Android Nougat, but hardly any tablets have that at the moment. What's slightly clunky is Huawei's choice of overlay. It's EMUI, which stands for Emotion User Interface. There's nothing wrong with it, it's just not the most refined overlay, but it depends on your preferences, really. It's not quite as good as Samsung's recently updated TouchWiz overlay. The notification tray looks quite different to stock Android. but for most tablet tasks like watching media and going online, you're going to be in an app like Google anyway, Google Chrome, so everything looks pretty normal there. One thing we do like to do with the software is the fingerprint sensor. It does link up, so where you would normally have, you can see here the on-screen buttons, which would go back, home, and recent apps. All of those functions you can actually use within the fingerprint scanner. So obviously the fingerprint scanner is nice and fast, as you'd expect. But when you're in an app, if you tap once to go back, it'll take you back a page. But also, when you're in an app, if you hold it down, it vibrates slightly and takes you to the home screen, which is really nice. And also, if you swipe from right to left, or indeed from left to right, it brings up your recently used apps. And it's a really cool way of using just one button to navigate the whole device, basically. So props to Huawei for doing that, we really like it. If you want a tablet, and it's weird that not many people do of late, I think most people buy a tablet and keep it for a few years, but if you're after an Android tablet in an 8-inch size, which is kind of a niche nowadays, this Huawei MediaPad M3 is well worth a look.